How's it going, everyone? Today, I'm doing a very different kind of video, but I thought it was worth bringing up just because it's so cool. Last week, Sony released PS4 Remote Play for iOS, which means you can play PS4 games on your iPhone, wherever you are, wirelessly. So it requires that both your PS4 and your phone have an internet connection. Of course, if you have a stronger connection, you'll have a better and smoother overall experience. To achieve the best connection though, it's definitely worth using an Ethernet cable with your PS4. I found it works really well though, even with Wi-Fi. It essentially works by streaming your PS4 to your phone. It's very similar to services like GeForce Now, where you're using the hardware from a computer, but in this case it's your PS4, to play on a less powerful device like your phone. It's so easy to set up. Just download the PS4 Remote Play app from the App Store. I'll leave a link down in the description for you guys. Then make sure your PS4 software is up to date with version 6.5, that the account you're using has the PS4 set as its primary one, and that you're signed into your PSN account on both your iPhone and your PS4. And that's it, you should be all up and running. If you find it still doesn't connect, you can always enter it manually by going to Remote Play in the PS4 settings and then adding the device. From there, you just have to enter the code from your PS4 to your phone. So the button layout can be quite difficult to use, especially if the game requires a lot of trigger use. And since you're only going to be streaming from your PS4 to your phone, there is input lag, so it's hard to play competitive games like Fortnite or Apex Legends. But more story-based solo games should work really well. It's also great that Sony have included haptic feedback with the buttons. Because there's no physical movement, it's nice to have that vibration response to actually know you've hit one. So you can play in both landscape and portrait. In portrait, the screen is pushed up to the top, and in landscape, the buttons are overlaid on top of the screen. The one thing I find really annoying is that you can't use your PS4 controller with Remote Play, which I just don't know why Sony would do that. But any other iOS supported controller should work really well. It's crazy how I remember playing classic games like Pokemon Red on my Game Boy Advance SP, but now you can play big AAA titles like GTA 5 or Red Dead Redemption 2 on your phone, which is just so cool. Anyway guys, thank you so much for watching. If you found the video helpful, hit that thumbs up and let me know what you think of Remote Play down in the comments, and I will see you all in the next one.